All right, so one of the questions we often get asked by, you know, entrepreneurs is, you know, what would be the right business structure for me? Can you give us a rundown of what are the values business structure and when to use one or another?
All right, so Leo, with recommending a correct business structure, you have to be careful not to, you have to be registered in order to give that advice, first of all. So I cannot give a blank advice here, but what I can tell you are the four main structures that generally are used in order to conduct business in Australia. The simplest way is to become a sole proprietor or a sole trader. And in that case, you apply for an ABN for yourself, which is linked to your own TFN, and all the profits that you make or losses get declared in your personal income along with your other income from salary or income from dividends or bank interest or rent, for instance. Okay, so it all comes into the one return. Once you go past a sole trader, then you are creating separate entities for conducting business. So the next one up is a partnership. Partnership is a very simplistic structure. You and me can become partners and conduct some business where if we make a profit, that gets distributed to your tax return and my tax return, half-half or in whatever proportion of the partnership agreement. So it's important for you to have a partnership agreement that determines how much each person will make, okay? But again, it's simplistic because that partnership does not basically hold any profits, it distributes it out. The one after that comes trusts. Okay, now trusts are a very different concept in Australia. It's quite unique in the way it gets business done. A trust is an entity that does not survive by itself. It has to be looked after by either an individual or a company. Okay, so when you set up a trust is a relationship between a beneficiary, which means the person who will get the money, and a trustee who is taking care of the money. Okay, so all the business gets done in the trust, everything is held in the trust, but ultimately the beneficiaries have the benefit of that income. Okay, and in Australia, generally speaking, you have a corporate trustee. A corporate trustee is a company that is specifically set up in order to manage the work or manage the business of the trust. So the company itself does no business. Okay, the company will have its name on the bank account. It will have its name on all the assets of the company, of the trust, but it will own nothing. It actually holds it on trust for the trust. And that trust will then conduct business. And the unique thing about a trust is that it distributes out the profit. Okay? So if there is a profit in the trustee can determine how to distribute and who to distribute the money to. So if it is a family trust, your family can be beneficiaries, your wife, your child, your parents and your brothers and sisters can become a beneficiary, okay? Well, whereas the other one is a unit trust, whereby it acts almost like a company. You buy the units in the trust, and depending on how many units you've bought, you get a share of the profit. So let's say if you bought 40% of the units, and I bought 60%, you can get 40% of the income and capital, and so I get 60%. So that is another way of doing business in Australia. It's a very common way of doing business because there are many CGT concessions that apply to it, and it keeps the money within the family if it's a family trust, okay? And the last one is a company itself. A company is obviously pays its own tax, is responsible for everything that it does. It can be sued in court, whereas a trust cannot be sued in court, okay? So when you start up a company, it has to be registered with ASIC, and every year you need to keep the registration up, and it costs you about $240 to $50 just to do that, whereas a trust is a one-off setup and no more fees, okay? So a company pays its own taxes and can get dragged into court, and if the director is in charge of the company and doing something wrong, he gets into trouble. So good thing to remember that. And obviously, there is a lot more to discuss. This is just touching the points at the top, right? Yeah.